A year is always made up of 365 days, right? Wrong. This is Can Explains the Leap Year. A leap year is a year with 366 days instead of the usual 365. An extra day is added at the end of February, which is usually only 28 days long. February 29th is the leap day. But why do we add an extra day? And what exactly are we leaping? Leap years happen every 4 years, but there are some exceptions. I'll explain in a bit. But first, let's talk about this thing we use every day called the calendar. In Canada and most parts of the world, we use something called the Gregorian calendar. It was named after this guy, Pope Gregory the 13th. The Gregorian calendar is based on a solar year, how long it takes the Earth to go around the sun. It actually takes a little more than 365 days for us to make a full trip around the sun, almost a quarter of a day more. So we end up falling a day behind schedule every 4 years. Julius Caesar actually introduced the 365-day calendar way back around 45 BC. It was called the Julian calendar, and it had leap days. But since the year isn't a perfect 365 and a quarter days, the leap days he added overcorrected. By the time it got to Pope Gregory's day and age, the calendar was off by 14 days. So he reformed it and added some new rules. A leap year has to be divisible by 4, but there are some exceptions. It can't be divisible by 100 unless it's divisible by 400. That's why the years 1600 and 2000 were leap years, but 1700, 1800, and 1900 weren't. Basically, skipping leap years every once in a while helps keep the calendar on track. It isn't perfect, but it will take a lot longer for us to go off track than it did before. So why is it called a leap year? In a normal year, every date moves forward one day of the week each year. For example, December 25th, Christmas Day, was on a Saturday in 2021, a Sunday in 2022, and a Monday in 2023. But in 2024, it will be on a Wednesday, leaping over the Tuesday. Get it? Leap year? Okay, so now we know what a leap year is and how the math works. But what would happen if we didn't have them? If we didn't have leap years, then the calendar and seasons would get out of whack. It would take hundreds of years, but eventually we'd end up having summer weather during Christmas and snow in July. My spring birthday would be full of colored leaves instead of rain and budding flowers. Basically, it would be really confusing. That's why we add a correction to the calendar. Okay, but what if you were born on a leap day? Well, let's say a kid was born on February 29th, 2012. That means in 2024, they have gone 12 times around the sun, making them 12 years old. But they would have only had 3 birthdays that actually landed on the date of February 29th. That's a leap year. And that's it for this Can Explains. For CBC Kids News, I'm Arjun Ram.